Hi to everybody and Purim Sameach. Thank you, my husband, such beautiful words. I'm going to say a few different ideas, but the theme running through, I think, all of them is going to be this idea of v'nahafochu, that everything just goes topsy-turvy. That's the whole, what happened in the miracle, right? Instead of the Persian armies and Haman being victorious, it was Am Yisrael, small nation scattered amongst all the nations. V'nahafochu hema yishlutu b'sonehem. And also nowadays, so many things are topsy-turvy. But before I speak a little bit about the what's happening in the world, I wanted to mention about my husband, something that I was thinking, something of v'nahafochu, and I think something that a lot of you may not know. You think now, my husband really likes the Americans, and he does, he really does. Many times I think more than the Israelis. No, he does. He likes the Americans. British, you know, a little question mark there, Rabbi Mays. I don't know. But now, at one time, my husband was really anti-American. Anti-American. I'll tell you, I'll give you the proof. Because he always tells his story. He said his mother, you know, his mother wanted him to go out with me and recommended it and pushed him to go out with me. And he said, no, I don't want to go out with her because she's American. And I don't like Americans, and Americans are messy, and you hate me. That's why you want to set me up in, with an American girl. So at one point, that's the proof. At one point, my husband was anti-American, and v'nahafochu. He really became such an admirer and an educator. I think he went from being anti-American to being, I think, the person, forget about being the rabbi, the person and the rav who's educated more Americans than anyone else alive. So v'nahafochu, it doesn't matter what you think now. You can change your thoughts, you can change your whole life, right? It doesn't happen, a lot of times in a day or two. It was a process. But my husband went the process, being anti-American to being so pro-American and so educating and giving values of Torah and Yirat Shamayim and Chesed to so many Americans that I think it's phenomenal. Anyway, that's one v'nahafochu. Now, another v'nahafochu is obviously this coronavirus. I mean, the whole world is a different world now. In a matter of 2-3 weeks. Like they're saying 50%, I just heard 50% may get the coronavirus and we're just putting it off and will there be a vaccine? It's like you don't go Dalet Amos without talking about corona, you know, right? You know, you say Dalet Amos Allah, Dalet Amos of corona. I mean, it's really a crazy thing, and it, you know, just shows how vulnerable, it can go from one minute to the next. The coronavirus is teaching us the same lesson as the Megillah in our focal. And on this coronavirus, you know, we're all taking measures and quarantine and whatever it is now. But back in the Megillah, I had a lot of questions, especially in the beginning of the Megillah. I spoke to the boys on Shabbos Parshat Zachar at night. So I want to also enlighten, you know, it's like when I called it to the boys, a contemporary creative reading on the Megillah. So when I have questions, I'm going to, you know, go for my questions. And my first question is on Vashti. V'tima'en hamalka Vashti lavo. The king calls her. What's the big deal? Right? My husband calls me, I run. Right? Everyone knows. Right? A wife, right? Always, all right. A wife is expected, you know, and again, she's making a big party for the women.
When I call you for Madame Thinks, you come. Okay, yes.
Yeah. We came here, right?
So she's making a big party for the women, and most of the time he let her celebrate. Achashverosh was a nice guy. He let her celebrate with the women. He calls her once. Come in for an hour. Say hello to my friends. Say hello to the guys, you know. I don't think it was something out of the ordinary. And I really don't understand why didn't Vashti come when the king calls her. Okay. All right, so off with her, you know, whatever. And then he has to pick somebody else. pick somebody else, a whole, they set up a whole harem now. Could you believe, let's say you were one of these women, before you can go see the king, there's 12 months that you have to bathe in these oils, right? Shisha chadashim b'shemen amor, v'shisha chadashim b'tamukei anashim. 6 months you have to have this oil, they're called mor, the mor kind of oil, and then these creams, tamukei anashim. 12 months of spa before you can go, what kind of business is this? I don't know how the country didn't go bankrupt with all using all the creams and oils for all these women. Just go, you know, you have a beauty pageant. It's 2 days, a week, 12 months that they have to lie in these, you know, in this spa. What was that all about? Then Esther comes, and right away, hey, guy, she finds favor. 1, 2, 3, she doesn't need the 12 months, she doesn't need the this, the Shem and Amor. What did Esther have, right? It doesn't say, what did Esther have that, hey, guy, you're right, these are good questions, right? What did Esther have? Why was she able to find favor so quickly and they rushed her and the whole thing, okay. Now she's there, I guess, you know, the little bit, she's either preparing her. Mordechai comes every single day, yom ba yom, right? He walks by there, ledat mashlom Esther, every day. You know, even Chazal tell us he's the husband, right? Whatever, what husband, the uncle who became the husband, you know, whatever, the guardian. But every day he has to come once a week, you know? You have to come every day to see why did he come every day. Then we have the big son of Asheresh. What does that whole thing come in there? They kill the king, they want to kill the king. It has nothing to do with anything. We never heard big son of Asheresh. And right after that, Vamelech Gidel et Haman. Why? Why did Haman? What did Haman merit that all of a sudden he rises to the top? He's second in command, right? A lot of questions, right? The Megillah doesn't give us the answers. It doesn't give the full story. So I will now tell you the full story. What really happened behind the scenes, right? It's a Hester. The Megillah is Hester. So it was hidden. They wanted to hide it. What are they hiding? They're hiding the coronavirus. Vashti had the coronavirus. And because it's so infectious and airborne, she gave it to all the women in the party. And they all went to their to cities and this. All the women in Shushan got the coronavirus. Right, not the men, because it came from Vashti. She was the source. I don't know what she ate, bats or lizards or whatever, right? And she got coronavirus. Everyone gets now. They were starting to develop the vaccine, but it wasn't yet fully developed, so it needed 12 months each day. 6 months it came through the Shemen Amor. They put it in an oily solution, and then the Tamrukei Nashim are different Tamrukei or Simamanim. It was in a vaccine form or whatever, you know, injection. So 6 months oil, 6 months injections, 12 months every woman had to have. Esther comes along now. Oh, it was pox. You saw it. There were pox on the face. Esther comes in. She has no pox. Right away, here we found a woman who doesn't have the corona. Esther didn't have the corona. Okay. How did Esther not have the corona? If everyone had the corona, how did Esther not have it? Because Mordechai, in addition to being the Gadol Ador and the Anshei Knesset Agdola, he also on the side was a businessman. You know, all the time Rashi had vineyards. You know, you had all the Tanayim. They all had professions, right? Mordechai had a profession. He had a biotech company, right? He had a biotech company, and he had invented a vaccine. Now, that was better than the vaccine, but it was also, you had to take it every day, right? It was better than what the other women were taking, but it was more effective, but she still had to continue taking it to make sure it would work, and that's why Mordechai came every day. And Hanan even added, he helped me on the papers here, Ladat Mashlom Esther, how's her welfare? How's she doing with the, you know, continuing the vaccine that I'm giving her? But Baruch Hashem, she did well, she found favor, right? She made it to, right? None of the other women were able to come because they weren't able to get over the coronavirus as, okay, now, Big Tana Vateresh. They were working in Mordechai's biotech company, right? They had it, yeah. They were working in Mordechai's biotech company. But what happens? There's industrial espionage. You have industrial espionage because there's another company. You know how it goes with the biotech companies. Everybody knows here, right? Industrial, right? So they heard, Bigtana and Seresh heard, that Ahasuerus was favoring the other company. So not that Mordechai told them, chas v'shalom, but on their own, right? Because the question is also, how did Mordechai know what Bigtana and Seresh were doing? Because he knew them because they were his workers. On their own, they want to kill Ahasuerus because Ahasuerus is taking the other company. And he told them, right? It was a whistleblower, right? Because he felt that they were doing the wrong thing. And he said, right, you don't go and kill the king because he's not giving us the contract. We'll get it. He was very upset with them. Now, who had the other company? Everyone knows. Haman. And that's why, right? Bigtan and Viserish were killed off. Mordechai was dealing with a difficulty in his biotech company because two of them, right? And meanwhile, Haman, he's the one that's making the other vaccine with the 12 months and the Shemen Amar and the Tamrukim. And it was working, it was starting to work. And he got the contract from the king, and the king, right? Although everyone knows that Mordechai's was better. So he starts saying, right, it's the Am Yisrael, it's this, it's, and then against the Jews, and then, but Esther, who's able to write the Yeshuat Hashem out of the virus and all the messages in the Megillah. But I just want you to know, it all starts from the coronavirus, and it's all with Haman and Esther, who was saved by Hashem to give the message of Lech Knoset Kol HaYudim, have everybody together, have a good Purim, and Baruch Hashem, Esther and Mordechai, with the help of Hashem, right, were able to overcome Haman and the coronavirus and everything, and Baruch Hashem, Yehudim Haita Ora V'Simcha V'Sasam V'Kar, and we should all have Ora Zatorah and Yom Tov and Tfilin and Torah and light and everything. Okay, anyway, everyone should have a Freilich Purim. No corona disease. We'll go to the right biotech company, get the corona. Okay, very good. Okay, finished. Okay, is enough? Venafohu.
I just hope nobody takes you seriously.
The principal,
it's a good poop time.
Yeah, Mordechai Minotaur, Rabbanit Mordechai Minotaur, where's it? It's Mordor.
Right.
Biotech, there you go.
Is that why they put the Ketamachos?